For a priority communication from Supreme Chancellor Leontine Suresh of the Galactic Republic.
It's a great honor to speak with the warrior who struck down the Emperor. The Republic needs your strong arm once again.
It isn't every day the leader of the Free Galaxy calls. How can I help you, Madam Chancellor?
The Hutt Cartel has invaded Republic space and seized the planet Mekeb. We will respond to this unprovoked act of aggression in full force. My War Council will be convening on Keylander Station in the Mekeb system. I ask that you join us immediately.
I'll set a course for the Mekeb system right now.
Proceed to the conference chamber on Keylander Station. I'll meet you there. Please hurry. We must act quickly and decisively against the Hutt's aggression.
Most cordial greetings. I am Zan Threlo, Republic Protocol Officer. Welcome to Mekeb and Keylander Station. Please hold all questions. Supreme Chancellor Suresh and her delegation are arriving.
Assembled friends. The Republic owes its continued survival to this brave Jedi. Entire worlds would be smoldering ruins if not for this hero's courage and sacrifice.
I was in the right places at the right times. Anyone in this room would have done the same, given the chance.
Perhaps, but would they have succeeded? You carry burdens that would break others, and we have need of that strength. Victory over the Empire lies within our grasp. But first, we must face a cowardly act of unwarranted aggression. Supreme Commander Malcolm.
13 days ago, the Hutt Cartel violated Republic space and seized the planet Mekeb. They've blockaded the system with 30 Ajur-class heavy cruisers.
Mekeb citizens have formally pledged to join the Republic if we respond to their crisis. We will not abandon them to the Hutt's brutality.
If we're willing to fight the Hutt Cartel for control of a planet that's been neutral up until now, we must have good reason.
Mekeb is a paradise. Quality of living standards significantly above the galactic average. Thriving mining and tourism industries. A world worth saving and having.
Severe atmospheric conditions on Mekeb make large-scale troop landings impossible. We need help from local resistance forces to pull this off.
One of Mekeb's business leaders, Shayla Mavesta, is awaiting you on the surface. I want you working closely with him.
We couldn't have freed Balmora or Corellia without help from the locals.
Shalem is a patriot who led his people to embrace the Republic. We mustn't desert him. Liberating Mekeb is your top priority, but I want the Hutt's ambitions ended permanently. Grandmaster Satil Shan has insight regarding our enemy's future plans.
The Jedi Council has meditated on the cartel's actions. We believe that Mekeb is a staging point for a larger attack on the entire galaxy.
The Hutts will not be allowed to expand their dominion at our expense.
If the Republic cuts a deal with the cartel, we could team up and take down the Empire together.
If there's to be any negotiation, I intend for it to be entirely one-sided. A shuttle will transport you to Shayla Mavesta's encampment on the surface. Go now, and show the galaxy the Republic is not to be trifled with.
You're one of the Republic heroes come to free my homeworld. You're just... Wow. I wish we'd joined the Republic ages ago.
When you stand with the Republic, it stands with you. We'll protect you from the Hutts, the Empire, and anyone who threatens your freedom.
That means a lot. The past 2 weeks have been a nightmare. I was here when the Hutts blocked all of Mekeb's comm channels. Haven't been able to get a signal from my family since. No idea what's happened down there.
The Hutts haven't been in control of your world for long. Most likely your relatives are safe in their homes.
That's what I keep telling myself. Don't know if they told you, but Mekeb's atmosphere's a real mess. Most ships get torn to bits by electrical storms on entry. My baby's got special ion shields to absorb the electromagnetic interference, but we're still in for a rough ride. Hopefully we won't land in little pieces.
It takes courage to fly through danger. Trust your instincts, and we'll be fine.
Never had a Jedi on my ship before. Wish I'd spruced up the inside a bit. My shuttle's prepped. Hop aboard, and we'll be on our way. You might want to take your anti-nausea stims, too.
honor my home, Master Jedi. I'm Shalem Avesta. The Supreme Chancellor promised us relief, but you're more than I ever hoped. My family helped found McCab. Avesta Mining has led our business council for decades. I was practically chief of state before the cartel's takeover. It wasn't an easy decision. But if joining the Republic is the only way to reclaim my home world's freedom, so be it.
The Empire wouldn't treat you any better than the Hutts. The Republic and the Jedi Order will protect this world.
I only ask that Mekeb's existing government retain a voice after this crisis ends. Ilosoth is a former mercenary with the Interstellar Regulators. Until recently, Mekeb's trusted private army and police force.
Quit when the Regulators sold out to the Hutts. I don't betray a client for credits.
Exceptions like him notwithstanding, the cartel bought off the Regulator forces and turned our former protectors against us.
How many ex-mercenaries do you have on your side? Enough to take down the rest?
Regulators who refused the Hutt buyout either ran or got shot for disloyalty before they could.
I still don't know why this has happened. We've conducted peaceful business with the Hutt cartel for years.
Casualty and damage reports coming in. Talao City got rattled pretty hard, but no injuries. Lucky.
That's the fifth groundquake since the Hutt's takeover. The last one leveled the Tygon mining colony. They're still pulling bodies from the rubble.
The Supreme Chancellor never said anything about groundquakes. Did you tell her about them?
I didn't think it was relevant. The tremors weren't notable. Not until recently, anyway. My niece Lemda is a respected geophysicist. She joined our resistance to prove there's a link between the groundquakes and the Hutt's deep core mining.
She was taking seismic readings on a deserted mesa when a whole company of Regulators swarmed in. We lost contact with her.
I sent search parties to bring Lemda back, but they aren't trained or equipped to fight a mercenary force of that size.
I have a feeling your niece discovered something, and the Hutts sent the Regulators to stop her from getting away.
That's my fear as well.
Getting reports from our search parties. Dozens of Regulators have pushed them back to the landing zone. We lose that, we'll never find Lemda.
You know the Regulators better than anyone. We could use your help out there.
I prefer that Ilosoth stay here. The Regulators don't know about our rebellion yet, but if they find out, I'll need his expertise to survive. Take my personal shuttle to Fryn Mesa. Lane Farrow is our man at the landing zone.
Shalem Avesta sent us. You're in charge here?
Reinforcements! We're saved! Prosk, come here! It's a Jedi!
Speak up, Lane. Not sure the whole Mesa heard you. My name's Prosk, in case Slick here didn't enunciate clearly. Kid's an accountant, barely knows which way to point a blaster. Can't say I'm much better. Used to be a mining foreman. We've set up barricades, but they're not doing much against the Regulators. What's the plan, boss?
When they charge, hold your ground and follow my lightsaber.
We'll do our best, Master Jedi.
Scouts report Regulators headed this way. Big group.
Everyone's manning a barricade. Find one and dig in. Master Jedi, I've never... Those Regulators... You're incredible.
I'll drink to that, Slick. Those mercs will think twice about hitting us again. We owe you one.
The mercenaries hope to overwhelm us. I only held them off thanks to your support.
You're making Slick blush, Master Jedi. Shalem sent you to find Lemda, right? Bring back his Geo... whatever niece and her research. We haven't had much luck there.
Her campsite was ransacked. The Regulators must have already captured her and confiscated all the research data. Shalem's right. She found something important.
This just became a rescue mission. If the Regulators have Lemda, where would they take her?
Scanners indicate no one except you has landed on or left the Mesa since the Regulators came. That means she's still here. Probably at one of their camps.
Great. There's half a dozen camps and no way to pinpoint which one she's at. Have to keep hitting them until she turns up.
I wasn't planning to let the Regulators stay on this Mesa. One way or the other, I'll find Lemda.
Those mercenaries sure will be surprised when you show up to ruin their day. A few of our search parties never made it back. You find any other prisoners, send them here.
Someone here might know how to slice the Regulators' comm frequency and find out what they're doing. Ask around, Prosk.
Slick takes charge with his big brain. On it, boss.
We'll hold this landing zone as long as it takes. Good luck.
Red team, come in. This is Vice Commandant Brevin. We've scanned heavy fire in your zone. Status report.
You kidnapped a harmless scientist. If you want to avoid another fight, let her go.
We didn't kidnap anyone, Jedi. We arrested a subversive. You're outnumbered by troops who have run ops in 30 systems. Our victory rate is 100%. You got lucky this time. It won't happen again. You should have taken the hint. I command the regulators, and I've got plenty of reinforcements to throw your way. Now they're angry.
Whatever the Hutts are paying, it's not enough. Quit while you're behind.
This op will be profitable long after you're gone.
It's Prosk, you read? We sliced the Merc's comm network. Hearing all kinds of interesting chatter. Whatever you're doing, it's paying off. The Mercs have pulled back. The landing zone's all ours.
Dig in and be ready, in case they come back.
Understood. We'll keep listening to the Merc's bellyache too. Might learn something we can use. Keep up the pressure.
Prosk, come in. We've taken out multiple regulator camps. Still no sign of Lemda.
Scouts report you've got those mercenaries chasing their own tails. Lemda has to be nearby. I'll take some men out and cover more ground.
Think you're clever? Killing my people? Slicing our comm channel? Every time you hit us, the Hutts crack down even harder on the nice people of Mekeb. They're dying because of you.
You can end this any time. You know my terms for your surrender.
I'm not the one who's about to die. Make your peace while you can.
Prosk, do you read? Another camp down and still no Lemda. Any luck on your end?
Hang on. Getting a distress call. It's her! Patching through!
Blast, is this stupid thing working? Hello? Hello?
We read you, Lemda. Your uncle sent a rescue team. The Republic's here, look!
Shalem didn't send more?
He told us you're a respected geophysicist. You look like a student. How old are you?
I received my doctorate 8 years ago. I was 16. Intimidated yet? My guards abandoned their posts and left me alone. You must be the murdering scum they went after. I broke free and ran to the nearest quake shelter. I'm the only person here. Sending you coordinates.
Don't move. The Mesa is crawling with regulators. Stay put and let us come get you.
I'm not setting foot out there. Wait, what was that noise? Is that on your end?
Lost her. They're blocking her signal. My team's close to that quake shelter. Meet you there.
No!
You got a lot of my friends killed today. Grevin said I could return the favor.
She's coming with me. Let her go and walk away. It's your only chance.
We're already earning enough from this job to retire. Once you're dead, we can do it in style.
The shelter's collapsing! We have to get out!
If the Hutts don't kill you, the ground quakes will. Surrender, and we'll lead you to safety.
Kill them!
There's never been a ground quake like that in Mekeb's history. Geologic instability has increased 1,000-fold since the Hutt takeover. Seismic readings and core stability fluctuations both indicate impending catastrophe. These ground quakes are the direct result of Hutt deep core mining that's going to destroy Mekeb.
When you say destroy Mekeb, I assume that means more than your tourist trade.
The fireworks will be a great crowd pleaser, but only if the crowds are in orbit. Every scrap of data I collected here proves the Hutt Cartel's deep drilling has destabilized Mekeb. These ground quakes are only the start. Entire mesas will collapse. After that, gravitational decay will strip away the atmosphere, kill everything. Mekeb will become totally uninhabitable.
The cartel and its forces are on Mekeb. Won't they die with everyone else?
Oh, they know what they're doing. They just don't care. And that mystifies me. I think there's a way to save Mekeb, but I need you to work with me. I'll warn you now. I'm snappish. Everyone says so. It's not personal.
I'd say you're handling yourself just fine under the circumstances.
My family is full of politicians. They say this is my way of rebelling. Did I mention I'm the one who convinced Uncle Shalem to contact the Republic? You're welcome.
You made it! We followed Prosk's signal and... Where's Prosk?
I'm sorry. He didn't... He's gone.
He gave his life saving Wenda. The best way to honor that sacrifice is by continuing the fight.
I know. I will. We'll get her back to Shalem. There's a clear path back to the landing zone, thanks to you.
Meet me at Uncle Shalem's office. We need to figure out a plan. Fast. This is nothing, Uncle. I've run the numbers. 2 days, maybe less. And your office is at the bottom of a sinkhole.
At least your expensive education has finally amounted to something.
Told you I'd repay that loan. Bet you're wishing you'd listened to me sooner. Not dismissed me as a loudmouth conservationist.
Master Jedi, Lambda told me of your incredible rescue. Words cannot convey my thanks. We suspected Mekeb was becoming unstable, but I had no idea things were this bad. We never should have let the Hutt Cartel establish their mining operation.
Lambda mentioned that there's a way to stop this disaster. What is it?
The regulators who held me hostage were a chatty bunch, mostly filthy language and bragging about their blasters, but the leader said something interesting. He mentioned Project Failsafe, a Hutt emergency plan if their mining went wrong. That mercenary believed the Hutts have something to instantly stabilize Mekeb.
Did the mercenary say anything else about Project Failsafe? Where it is? How it works?
The conversation dried up when you started attacking their camps. Not that I'm ungrateful.
Millions could die while we wait for the Hutts to act. We need to claim Project Failsafe for ourselves before it's too late.
Talos City. The Hutt Embassy database.
Ilasov's right. Data on Project Failsafe would be stored in the Hutt Embassy's computers in Talos City. Unfortunately, that's under cartel control. We need Chief Herquil, Talos City's former security commander. He and a few loyal men have a hidden camp outside the city. They'll get you inside the city and embassy.
We'll head there now. Tell Chief Herquil to get ready.
The Hutts control Talos City and the surrounding area. We'll have to land a shuttle in the countryside. Expect plenty of regulators. Chief Herquil's camp is hidden at these coordinates.
Don't die. You're all we've got.
Chief Herquil, Shalem Avesta sent us. He says you know a way into the Hutt Embassy.
If I'd known a Jedi war hero was coming, I'd have cleaned myself up and made some lunch. Hutt Embassy's locked up tight. Used to have a fancy-pants bureaucrat helping us inside, Representative Eklund, but he's gone quiet. Probably dead. Good news is, the cartel hasn't changed anything at their embassy. Got the same turrets, droids, passcodes I set up for them. Lazy Hutts.
When this is all over, we'll have to thank the Hutts for making our job simple.
They may be stupid, but they're still pretty good at killing folks. You want inside the Hutt Embassy, you'll have to finesse 3 layers of security. First layer is heavy turrets in the courtyard. The only good thing to come out of these ground quakes is that they expose the turret power generators. Overload those, and turrets lose their punch.
I doubt the Hutts left those generators unguarded. How hard will it be to reach them?
City's under curfew. Streets are crawling with Hutt loyal regulators. Security layer 2 is the embassy's main door. 3 meters of reinforced Durasteel. Even a lightsaber would take hours to cut through. But the door will unlock for a diplomatic passcode. You can generate one by accessing the government building secure terminal.
Get inside the government building, slice the secure terminal for a passcode, and get out. Next?
Last but not least are the security droids. Top-of-the-line Arcanian models. Nasty disposition. Shoot intruders on sight. Good news is, they can be reprogrammed. The droid control station in my old security HQ will do the trick.
We could use some allies. Those droids will do nicely. We'll take it from here, Chief.
Hit those objectives, and I guarantee you'll get inside the embassy. Whether you find your answers is a different matter. If Representative Eklund's still alive, maybe help him escape? He's a fuss budget, but basically all right. I'll keep a comm channel open when I can.
Acknowledging flight and code. Greetings, Senior Command Unit 223.
Good to know Chief Herquill's codes are still valid.
Feel free to inspect the embassy. You will find everything in order.
Wait, please. I'm an unarmed civilian. Representative Eklund with the Mekeb Provisional Authority Council. I'm the official liaison to the Hutt Cartel. Whatever you need, I'll make sure you get it. Just don't hurt me.
I'm working with Shalem Avesta. He sent me to get information on the Hutt Cartel's plans.
And he thought the best way to do it was to attack their embassy? Typical. Like it or not, the Hutt control Mekeb now. Our only option is to cooperate, make the best of our new situation. Instead, Shalem stirs up trouble. He doesn't realize how much worse the Hutts could make things for us.
The Hutts aren't here to rule Mekeb. They're here to destroy it. Their deep drilling has destabilized the planetary core.
Why would they do that? Mekeb is an investment for them. If they destroy the planet, they lose their assets. Besides, most of the Hutts are here on the surface. If the planet explodes, they go with it. It's illogical.
Geological readings show this planet is coming apart. But we think the Hutts have a project fail-safe to deal with the situation.
Knowing Shalem, you'll risk anything to find it. Well, I'll save some lives and help quash this rumor for good. If this project fail-safe exists, there must be some record of it in the Embassy's archives. I'll get you access to them. But the Hutts are on high alert. They've already summoned reinforcements. You'll have to deal with them. I'll meet you in the archive room.
Just do your part and leave the guards to me. I don't want you getting hurt.
The guards won't target me. That's why I prefer to travel separately. You worry about those reinforcements. I'll make sure we can access the Hutt archives. Good luck!
Security protocols have been disabled. Eklund came through.
Almost. I ran when I heard the fighting. Let me finish this. The Hutt in charge of Mekeb is named Taboro. If Project Failsafe exists, there should be some reference to it in his communication logs.
I assume you've met Taboro. What's your take on him?
He isn't your typical Hutt. Quick profits matter less to him than long-term gains. Here, a holo from someone named Vedrig has a Project Failsafe tag. Let's hear what it says.
Greetings, O great and glorious Taboro. I'm happy to report that Project Failsafe is both on schedule and under budget. Your grand arc is approaching completion.
Ever met this Vedrig before? He sounds like a used speeder salesman.
I've heard the name once, but this is the first I've seen of him. Hideous fellow.
As these schematics illustrate, the arc's ingenious outer layer will completely shield the vessel and its precious contents from Mekeb's atmospheric unpleasantness. The cargo hold will store your entire Isotope 5 stockpile, while your chosen few companions travel in luxurious comfort on the Ark's upper decks.
Taboro's building a starship to evacuate the Hutts and transport this Isotope 5 off-world. Whatever that stuff is, it's worth Mekeb's destruction.
We've never mined anything called Isotope 5. It must be something the Hutts discovered.
Mighty Taboro, may I suggest replacing the standard passenger cabins with deluxe suites more suited to a Hutt of your stature? I can easily add them before the Ark's completion.
This hollow is recent. Vedrig is still building the Ark. That means there's time to steal it for ourselves and evacuate the planet. Based on the schematics, we'll have room for the whole population if we convert the cargo hold to carry passengers.
There are only so many places the Hutts could hide such a massive project. We have to find it.
Evacuating this planet will require someone with resources and contacts. Shalem Avesta has both.
I'll scour these archives and transmit everything I find to Shalem. Given the circumstances, I feel rather unsafe remaining here.
There's a shuttle pad nearby. If you remove the guards and unlock the shuttles, we could all fly away safely.
You're alive. Guess my advice worked, huh? Shalem told me to patch you through right away.
We're already analyzing the project failsafe plans Representative Eklund transmitted to us. They're sickening. To borrow the Hutt is masterminding the greatest crime in galactic history. With Vedric's Ark, they'll escape Makeb and leave us all to die. We can't let that happen.
The Deveronian is more salesman than soldier. If we pressure him, he'll turn against the Hutts and give us the Ark.
No doubt Vedric's sticking close to his project until he's paid.
I matched the Ark's construction site map to topographic readings. The Ark's being built at a secret facility inside the giant sphere. That's a big tourist trap, a mesa with a hollow interior. Too dangerous to colonize, but perfect for hiding an Ark's construction.
If the Ark is the Hutt's only escape, they'll have it locked down tight. What security measures will we face?
Not sure yet, Master Jedi. But we have probe droids gathering intel right now. Contact me when you're the giant spear. I'll help you plan this attack. It won't be an easy fight.
Don't look at me. I've got a city to evacuate. Good luck.
Ilasov, we're at the giant spear. What have you got for us?
We set probe droids to scan the zone ahead of you. Their readings, not good news. Regulator fire teams are patrolling the site. Some of Vice Commandant Grevin's finest, backed by top lieutenants from the Hutt Cartel. Everyone's packing military hardware.
Any chance Grevin is commanding these forces? It'd be nice to have another talk with him.
Doesn't look like it. Too bad. That son of a Hutt deserves to fry with the rest of his two-faced traitors. The Ark construction site's behind a triple-bladed durasteel blast door. Takes three separate keycards to open the thing. Only cartel representatives carry them. Guess the Hutts only trust the regulators up to a point. You need to find the cartel's top lieutenants and get their keycards.
Thanks for the intel and advice. We'll contact you again when we unlock that blast door.
I'll keep searching the files in case there's anything else. Good luck.
Ilasov, we're through the blast door.
Good. Seal it behind you. There ought to be a control panel nearby. Scramble those security codes. That'll keep reinforcements from following you. Schematics for the Ark construction site are a mess. Can't tell what half the symbols mean. Just do whatever it takes to secure the Ark, and good luck.
Insane. My men are working triple overtime and we're still falling behind.
Work faster.
That's not... Look, we both know Vedric's skimming off the top. If this keeps up, we'll never finish the Ark.
You got a big mouth, Tiero. Maybe I'll shut it for you.
Put that blaster down now, or this man's conscience will be the least of your concerns.
Wait. You. You're who Taboro's yelling about. Give me a hand here. She's worth a fortune dead.
Who do you think powers that thing? Live Jedi?
Republic, huh? Don't know what you're doing on Makeb, but thanks. These cartel idiots won't listen to reason. I try calling for help and get a blaster shoved in my face. The Hutts work us to death, treat us like slaves. No, like animals.
We're here to commandeer the Ark for the people of Makeb. Once it's secure, you and your men will be freed.
We're working 18-hour days. No breaks, no visits home. It's all on Vedric's orders. My men break their backs, building his Ark while he steals everything not bolted down. Thanks to Vedric, the Ark's weeks behind schedule. My crew can't finish the ship while that slimy Deveronian's selling off its components.
Fedrig. Fast talker, horns on his head, likes kissing up to the Hutts.
Oh, you know him. I'll tell my crew to lay low. Put Fedrig in his place, and we'll help you out however we can.
Got the best Ugnaught engineer in 4 sectors on retainer. She's a genius with electroplumbing.
You'll have the classiest refresher in Coruscant, boss.
Still can't decide what to put in the sonic shower. Felucian glimmerstones look so elegant, but I love Ryloth'ian onyx tile.
Feel free to go solve your interior decorating problem. This entire facility is now Republic property.
You're that Republic hero Taboro's screaming about on the Hollow. The cartel's so worried they're paying double to finish the arc ahead of schedule. That's on top of what they're offering to kill you. Never let it be said I'm not generous in defeat. You can have this incredible marvel of starship design at a 20% discount. 30%?
I don't think you understand the gravity of your situation.
Gravity, huh? Good one. I admit the ship needs a little work, but she's almost ready to fly. Besides, being incomplete means there's room to customize. Let me live, and I'll have this baby ready to leave the atmosphere in no time. You won't find a better offer, trust me.
Don't count on being trusted, but you can work for our people.
Hello, Fedrig. Time to earn your pay.
Looking forward to it. Could you spare some culto first?
Haven't had contact with the outside in weeks. This is Foreman Tierra, and Republic forces calling from Giant Spear. Does anyone read?
Loud and clear, Tierra. We sent those Republic forces. What's the Ark status? Is it secure?
Go ahead. Give him the bad news about the Ark.
It's incomplete, but is the Ark that important?
Foreman, this is Shalem Avesta. Makeb's core is tearing apart, and we can't stop it. That Ark is our people's only hope of escape. If I send you every able body I have and guarantee your safety, can you finish the Ark in time to evacuate our world?
I'll blasted well try.
The Hutts are surely organizing a counterattack. We're forming a battle plan to defeat it. We'll brief you back here. Hurry!
If the Hutts are striking back, should we leave these workers and the Ark unguarded?
You lock the main blast door. We can hold out until reinforcements get here. Fedrig kept a private shuttle pad nearby. You can take his transport while we get to work.
We can't thank you enough for securing the Ark, Master Jedi. You turned certain death to a chance for survival.
The Hutts won't give up the Ark without a fight, and they have an army. Our battles have just begun.
You're more right than you know. We intercepted priority signals from the cartel. Every regulator in this hemisphere has been ordered to retake the Ark at all costs.
Ilasov, organize a defense force. Anyone willing to fight gets a blaster and a ride to the Ark's construction site. Go, now.
We'll need your shuttle navigator. Come on.
Shalem, contact your allies. We'll need all the help we can get.
Already done. Impending doom was an excellent motivator. My people are scouting for regulator activity and reporting what they find. We've identified one major staging area.
The Fingers. Originally one mesa, until a quake redecorated the place. Now it's held together by a series of interconnected energy fields, light bridges.
The regulators store heavy artillery and weapon caches there. If those mercenaries rearm, they'll blast us to oblivion.
Without their most powerful armaments, the regulators won't be nearly as dangerous. They might even surrender.
We'll certainly give them something to think about. We know the regulators' army also includes war droids and a battle platform. We're still scouting for those.
Translation: he's finding lots of ways to risk your life.
You're trying to save your people, and we're your best chance. There's nothing to apologize for.
Who was apologizing?
Once you've destroyed the artillery and weapon caches in the Fingers, contact me. I should have additional targets by then. Good luck.
Shalem, come in. The regulator's weapon caches are all destroyed.
Outstanding. I hope you're ready for more. We've detected an army of war droids massing for an attack. If those Boar droids make it across that bridge, they'll slaughter everyone in their path, including us.
If the Hutts can set up a light bridge, we can take it down.
I had something slightly more destructive in mind. The war droids are holding position for now, but you could lure them out by transmitting false orders from the mercenary army's comm towers. Once the droids are halfway across the light bridge, you could deactivate it. Drop the whole army into the depths.
What a waste of perfectly good droids. Is there any way to reprogram them to fight for us?
The master control is out of our reach. There simply isn't time. Slice into the mercenary comm towers, transmit the false marching orders, and deactivate the light bridge at the perfect moment. Good luck.
The droid army is gone for good. The regulators will think twice before setting foot on that light bridge.
I know the cost per unit of those war droids. Between them and the weapons you destroyed, the regulators are over 300 million credits in the red.
If all they care about is money, there has to be a credit figure where retreat becomes the better option.
Our foes appear determined to throw good money after bad. We finally tracked down the main mercenary base. Floating battle platform called the Storm Carrier. Vice Commandant Grevin, the mercenary leader, is gathering troops there. We can't let Grevin's forces reach the Ark. The only way to stop the Storm Carrier is by overloading its power reactors to meltdown.
Should we eliminate Vice Commandant Grevin, or is he worth more as a prisoner?
Grevin knows the Hutts won't tolerate failure. I doubt he'll let himself be captured. Sending you the Storm Carrier's coordinates. Our scouts report there's a regulator shuttle near your position. You can fly it directly to the enemy and take them completely by surprise. Everything's riding on this. May fortune smile on us all.
Warning. Warning. Reactors 2, 5, and 8. Approaching critical mass. Carrier cooling system has been disabled.
I knew you were ruthless. But you'd destroy this carrier, kill everyone aboard just to make a point. If I didn't have to shoot you, I'd give you a job.
You're the ones who sent those regulators to kill Lemda, aren't you? I remember you from our holo chats.
I've been looking forward to this. Once you're dead, the cartel's paying us more than we'd earn in a lifetime from this planet's idiot government. McKeb can burn for all we care. So can your Republic. Isotope 5 will change everything. Once they're done mining McKeb, the Hutts will own this galaxy.
The cartel is destroying McKeb to mine Isotope 5? What makes that substance worth all this?
No point telling you. Won't do any good. You've cost me a fortune today, but I can still recover my expenses. Time to settle your debt.
Meltdown in progress. Abandon ship. Repeat. Abandon ship.
People of Makeb, your heroes return.
Watch out. Uncle Shalem's running for president of whatever planet we all move to.
This heroic Jedi led us to victory against the Hutt treachery. Now we have freedom and an Ark that will deliver us to safety.
I know you're all scared. You have good reason. But the time for fear is ending. The Hutts only control you when you are broken and despairing. Look to your neighbors, your friends, your loved ones for strength. Through compassion and hope, you will survive this. May the Force be with you.
I meant what I said. All of it. The Ark is safe, and we'll soon have it ready to fly. We've earned a moment to celebrate. Especially you.
Maybe Lemda can show me the sights. This might be our only chance to relax.
I'll relax when I'm not standing on a planet that's falling apart. But I appreciate the offer.
We finally have Mighty to borrow the Hutt's attention. Calling to congratulate us, old friend?
You don't frighten us, Taboro. If you had anything left to hit us with, you wouldn't be talking.
Spare us your empty threats, Taboro. Makeb is doomed, and the Ark is our only escape. If we give it back, we're all dead.
Do you honestly expect us to believe that? You've been lying since you arrived on Makeb.
I recognize where that droid was attacking. Tarlum, it's a small city without defenses. I'll summon a shuttle to take you there. Please, save my people.
I don't care how big Tabaro's weapon is. I've never met a machine that could defeat a Jedi.
I'm sending an emergency signal to the Republic. We need a science expert down here. If Taboro's telling the truth about Isotope 5, we're still stranded, and that Hutt's going to slaughter us all. Hurry to Tarlum and stop his droid.
What's the galaxy coming to? Hutt's invading, planets cracking in half, and now that, whatever it was. Somebody tell me what that was.
It appeared to be a droid, Mayor.
Here I was, thinking it was a shiny Wookiee on stilts wearing turbo lasers for a hat. A droid indeed. Who the blazes are you?
I'm a Jedi Knight, here to protect you, on behalf of Shalem Avesta and the Galactic Republic.
Thought as much, but with the lightsaber and all. Good.
This mesa's already collapsing. Now, I've got wounded people everywhere, and all the working shuttle pads are outside town.
You obviously can't stay. What will it take to get your people out of here safely?
It's not a question of resources. We're racing disaster here. No telling when this mesa will fall apart.
Mayor, we're getting emergency alerts. The Hutts are landing reinforcements, mercenaries, and more of those droids.
Lovely. I'm the one-legged woman at the droid-kicking contest.
They're holding the shuttle pads. We'll never get off the mesa unless someone drives the enemy off.
Leave the Hutt forces to me. I'll open the routes out of here. You be ready to move your people.
Just clearing off the pads isn't enough, though. We need to stop the Hutts from landing more reinforcements until we've all evacuated.
We could erect energy shields, Mayor. Cover the pads so they can only be used for flying out.
Solar air! You're actually useful! If we got you some energy shields, could you set them up at each landing pad?
You can count on me. Complicated missions are my specialty. I'll clear the shuttle pads and make sure they won't work for the Hutts.
Gather the wounded, prep for evacuation on the double. We are leaving.
Take these energy shields. Activate them at the landing pads. Good luck.
That's far enough, thank you.
I doubt even the Force can stop me from pulling this trigger. Best not to try.
Please, the next groundquake could destroy this mesa. Kill us all!
Then let's keep the negotiations brief, hmm? We've done no harm to these people. All we seek is the droid's isotope 5 power supply.
Mayor, is this Imperial telling the truth? None of your people were injured in the attack?
Just a few bumps and bruises to get our attention. Don't much care for having a blaster stuck at my head, though.
No time for debate. Let us have the isotope 5 or we'll be forced to execute the prisoners. I'm sure no one wants that.
Whatever your mission is, it ended the moment you crossed me. Drop your weapons or die.
We cannot return empty-handed. If we must die, it will be as soldiers. Kill them!
The Imperial warned you this would happen. Why couldn't you just let them go?
I didn't kill these people. That Imperial did, and I made sure he paid for it.
I should contact Shalem. Let him know we're bringing wounded.
Thank goodness you're... Wait. Where's Mayor Erkins?
We have more problems than Taboro. Imperial forces came here to retrieve samples of Isotope 5. They killed the mayor.
What a loss. And now we have the Empire to contend with.
We're ready to evacuate, but many of our people were wounded in the attack.
We've established a medical triage center. I'm sending the coordinates to there. Get your people to it. I've also relocated to a new camp near the Ark construction site. I'm transmitting coordinates. Meet me here to plot our strategy.
Have we managed to investigate Taboro's claims about the Ark's fuel supply?
A Republic engineer just arrived. He's analyzing the Ark's schematics now. Get here as soon as you can.
Ah, you're here. Good news. Tarlem's refugees evacuated safely. And no fresh reports of Taboro's droids. You bought us time, and we'll need it. This is Gazadar, one of the Republic's top engineers, and a brave man for coming down here.
Couldn't pass up a chance to thank the legendary Jedi who saved Coruscant. I was there when you stopped the planet prison.
I'm surprised you know anything about that. It wasn't common knowledge at the time.
I heard about it well after the fact. Nothing like belatedly realizing you escaped certain doom.
Gaz just made it through the analysis of the Ark schematics. I'm sad to report that Taboro wasn't lying.
The Ark was specifically built to run on Isotope 5. It's the only energy source capable of pushing that massive vessel through Makeb's atmosphere.
Those war droids Taboro sent to attack Tarlem also ran on Isotope 5. Maybe we could convert their power cores into fuel?
You'd be acquiring it in such small amounts that we'd never get enough before Makeb's core goes critical.
Then we need the real brains behind the Hutt Cartel's operations here. Dr. Juvard Ilip Ogarab. And we know where he is.
Whoa. The only 5-time winner of the Beodur Science Prize is on Makeb? Are you saying he designed the Ark?
Probably those droids, too. Dr. Ogarab has been holed up at the Sanctuary Research Complex since before his people invaded. If anyone knows about Isotope 5, it's him.
Why would a Hutt scientist help us at all? Isn't he with the cartel?
Dr. Ogarab is well-respected across the galaxy. For a Hutt, he's pretty reasonable. The Sanctuary Research Complex is one of the most advanced experimental laboratories in the galaxy. It's on an isolated mesa completely under Hutt control.
There's no telling what sort of defenses a genius like Dr. Ogarab has there. And you'll be going in blind.
There are data access terminals on Sanctuary's testing grounds. Try accessing one. It might let you disable any unwelcome surprises. Otherwise, good luck.
I promise to stay alive. You'll be worried sick the whole time I'm gone, won't you?
I've been worried sick since before you landed on Makeb.
We're only getting one chance at this. We can't afford to be wrong about anything. Dr. Ogarab has the knowledge we need.
And please, for the love of science, don't hurt Dr. Ogarab. I didn't bring a way to preserve his brain.
It's high time you Republic agitators showed up. Taboro and his brutes have this entire facility captive. I was wondering if you'd ever bothered liberating it.
The Republic sent me here to protect its people from a Hutt invasion. The word you're looking for is Defender.
No offense intended. I'm I'm confident you are quite the hero. There are many on this mesa being forced to work as slaves. We would be honored to aid your attack. We possess detailed data on the lethal security grid to borrow installed across the mesa. We'll help you destroy it so you can enter the main complex and we can escape.
If you have information, now's the time to share it. Things are about to get loud.
I am transmitting data on several key objectives. Each will provide you ample opportunity to convey your displeasure with Taboro. Stand by. Follow those instructions precisely. You'll not only gain access to the main complex, you'll destroy Taboro's security grid. We'll speak again when you reach the main complex entrance.
Taboro's security grid is down. We're entering the main complex.
Splendiferous! You've eliminated many of that bully's unforgivably barbaric thugs, but more remain inside the complex. Once you've eliminated them and disabled any internal defenses, we will evacuate Sanctuary. Your heroics are most appreciated, and we will return the favor. It is obvious you came for the illustrious Dr. Ogarov. We're transmitting his coordinates so that you may quickly find him. Best of luck.
Yo kanta patachawa murmur. Moki ilema wata. La joba numbotafa avatikuna chi tu nik na noria.
Jobei tupa. Kasoya rikoi radoe tapa chapapa.
The Republic hasn't made friends with the Empire, and the Doctor doesn't work for us. Not yet, anyway.
Ava oska bunyo. Oscar.
Tuti puna puna. Manchi kabuk nune slimo.
Ochima. Uban chome alipa isti patoka.
Cherish nincompoop. You can see why I was forced to lend my brilliance to your assault. I'm glad you're here. My apologies for the earlier subterfuge. A necessary contrivance. Taboro seized control of my defenses and was watching me closely, but I am no one's prisoner.
You helped us defeat your own security grid. I thought your people only spoke in Huttese.
All Hutts can speak your language. We simply choose not to. Given the circumstances, I prefer to avoid linguistic misunderstandings. We have complementary goals. You want what Taboro possesses, and I wish very much not to die. Provide me with transport off this doomed planet. I will aid your efforts to recover the isotope 5 fuel rods that power Taboro's Ark.
You're the only halfway decent Hutt we've met in a while. I suppose that should count for something.
How fortunate for me that my brethren have profoundly lowered your expectations. I have a personal shuttle here. It's large enough to accommodate us all. Thanks to you, we can now fly. We should leave before Taboro sends an army to kill us. Take me to your allies, and I will explain what must be done.
Doctor, it's such an honor. I'm so glad we weren't forced to kill you.
We held up our end of the bargain and got you to safety. Tell us about Isotope 5, and how to fuel the Ark.
Isotope 5, Taboro's great discovery at the center of Makeb. Something truly unique in all the galaxy. And worth destroying this planet to obtain. Imagine a substance as light as shimmer silk, but stronger than Durasteel. It distorts gravity and electromagnetic fields so predictably that it can be refined into fuel. Isotope 5 has limitless potential to remake this galaxy. Those droids you battled were first-generation prototypes. Playthings.
Are you saying there are even more advanced versions of those droids? How many? What are their capabilities?
Taboro has dozens of prototype weapons. Their capabilities vary based on whatever creative inspiration moved me that day. I crafted a beautiful set of Isotope 5 fuel rods to power Taboro's Ark. Some of my finest work, but you'll never see it. According to my data stream, Taboro has increased mining production to maximum levels. Makeb's destruction will arrive far ahead of schedule. You have a spacecraft, yes? We should depart immediately.
We're not leaving our people behind. If Taboro's drilling has accelerated Makeb's destruction, turning it off should slow it back down.
I fear it won't be as easy as flipping switches. The platforms and their control rooms will be heavily defended.
Everything on this planet has been an ordeal. I'd hate to break our perfect record. But don't worry, those drilling lasers are going offline.
If they don't, I doubt we'll see each other again. I'll have a transport to the mining platforms prepped for you immediately. Keep us apprised of your progress.
Thanks for the assist. Private Vandalic, 8th Imperial Infantry. Might keep your distance. Insides leaking out.
Don't try to move. We'll transport you out of here.
Generous, but a waste of effort. Not much time. So listen, wasn't always Imperial military. Born on Macab. Caught wind of the Hutt takeover. And volunteered for this. Defend my old home.
You don't sound like a typical Imperial. Didn't realize the military was recruiting outside their space.
Was this or mining? Bad choice, looking back. Orders were to steal Isotope 5. But I wanted to help your evacuation. Still have friends and family here. Shutting down drills, not enough. Need to open emergency release valves at primary control center. Reduce core pressure.
You're a soldier, not a geologist. How did you figure all this out on your own?
I grew up on these platforms. My father was a foreman. Use slicer spike in control center's mainframe. Override Hutt security lockout. Take control. Vent the core. Control center's heavily guarded. Sorry, that part's on you. Please get my people off this rock.
Is there a message you want delivered to your friends and family?
No time. Wish I could stay.
Lemda, Gez, we're at the drilling site's primary control center. An Imperial soldier, an ex-native, told us to open the emergency release valves. He said it was the only way to release planetary core pressure. Do you agree?
Tectonic vibrations are still off the charts. Coranto Mesa just exploded. Good thing we're not there. Those drilling lasers were working overtime. The heat buildup beneath the planet's crust is massive. Venting the core would cool things off.
Sounds like it's our only option. Slicing the mainframe now.
It's working. Readings show seismic activity falling quickly. That should buy you enough time to get the Ark's fuel rods.
We're still cutting it awfully close. Can we use this equipment to reverse the core's damage?
If we had months, maybe. But we don't. We've had an interesting development while you were gone. Dr. Ogarab isn't the only Hutt on Macab who's changing sides. The local Hutt cartel leaders, minus Taboro, want to negotiate with you personally. Hurry back to camp and meet us in the diplomatic tent.
You sold us out to that maniac Taboro? Now that he's turned on you, we're supposed to save your skins? Incredible.
Had we known Taboro was insane, we never would have supported him. He is no longer Hutt Cartel. We formally shun him. However, in breaking ties with Taboro, we find ourselves stranded on Macab with you. We are prepared to offer generous compensation for seating and cargo space aboard the Ark.
Cargo? Are you delusional? Your bodies take up more room than a dozen good people.
Ah, one of the Republic's greatest heroes. Just the person we could use to bring some wisdom and perspective to the discussion.
Let me see if I understand. Taboro's former friends got on his bad side. Now they need to get off Macab, so they've come to us?
The major cartel leaders have decided Taboro is bad for business. They want peace.
Most revered Republic champions, my masters apologize for this unfortunate situation. Surely we can reach a state of mutually beneficial recompense and earn passage aboard the Ark?
My people deserve rescue. The Hutt Cartel's leaders can't just beg their way out.
Shalem's right. But these are the most powerful Hutts in the galaxy. We can name our price to save their lives, and think what that means for defeating the Empire.
You think we should combine forces with the Hutts and attack the Empire together?
We can't lose sight of the real enemy here, or how much the Hutts fear you. Taboro has lost his mind, and these cartel leaders know it. They can't go back to him. They need us.
Honored Republic heroes, you are known for mercy and greatness. Can you find it within yourselves to forgive our profound error in judgment?
It's easy to have a change of heart when your life is in danger. Show me that you won't revert back to your old ways once you're off Macab.
Honored Republic negotiators, my masters will happily continue debasing themselves, but Macab's time grows short. If you provide safe passage for my masters and their cargo, they will fully commit the cartel to an alliance with the Republic. Surely you find this agreeable?
Inform your masters that they'll be allowed to board the Ark with the other refugees. Personal belongings will be loaded as space permits. First priority will be given to food, medicine, and other items essential to survival. A rhodium-plated statues will not qualify. We'll negotiate exactly what responsibilities the cartel has to the Republic once this crisis is over. We'll expect full cooperation.
My masters wish no further hostilities with you. The offer is accepted without condition.
I think you're the first in galactic history to force the Hutts into a deal they can't afford. Now all we need are those fuel rods. Dr. Ogarab is with Shalem. You should coordinate with them.
The cartel has deserted you, Taboro. You have no allies left. Don't be a fool. Give us the fuel rods.
Taboro, there's something very wrong with you. Listen to what you're saying. It doesn't make sense.
That inbred imbecile has abandoned all sanity. You'll have to dig the Ark's fuel rods by force. His palace is a testament to my artistry. I poured my spirit into designing lethal defenses. I also left myself a private entrance inside.
A secret back door? I'm starting to like you, Ogarab.
My charms are legion. Taboro will have far more than my inspired designs guarding him. His most lethal soldiers and Isotope 5 droids patrol every corridor.
We'll hold this position until you get back.
Without those fuel rods, millions will die. If you can't get them, I'm canceling your parade.
Tell your people not to worry. We'll get those fuel rods no matter what.
Be safe.
You now have coordinates and the security code to my secret entrance. Once you're inside, contact me for more information. Don't die.
Your hidden entrance appears to be unguarded, Doctor.
Of course. Taboro doesn't even know it exists. He has no eye for such exquisite detail. He is also despairingly predictable, and almost certainly ranting away in his throne room while clutching the fuel rods to his bosom. I am transmitting procedures to defeat the security protocol separating you from Taboro. Follow them precisely. I'll be unable to reach you via holo after this.
We can take things from here. You've been most helpful. The Republic will remember your cooperation.
Perhaps your Supreme Chancellor will reward me with my own private laboratory. The planet Tisharon would be perfect. A last word of advice. Taboro asked for some rather unorthodox droid designs. It's possible he actually built a few. If so, good luck with them.
Yuna, Niska, Chananda, Wachi. Kospaini, Hontinka. La Jobanum Botafa, Avatikun Achido Nignanolia.
This planet may not be around much longer, but its people will always be part of the Republic.
Obey Tuta. Kasoya Rikoi, Radoe Tapa, Chotopa. Ujima. Uban Chonea Lipa Isti Patoka.
How do you plan to kill me, Taboro? Your awful breath or rolling over?
What you got there, Kira?
the cab.
Canuta Belt Castuta, Nona Pachisa, Tecaya Shrek Rolla, Wosca Qua Bobana. Huni Joka, Nutra, Chipawa, Una Chichi Tua.
You left us no chance to get you out of here alive, Taboro. Goodbye. The Ark's fuel rots, as promised. Taboro's gone, along with his entire supply of Isotope 5.
The whole planet felt it. Lemba says the explosion triggered a chain reaction in the planet's core. If you have unfinished business, better make it quick. I'll take the fuel rods and get our people to work installing them. I left a shielded shuttle here at the camp. It's your ticket off Makeb. The rest of us are taking the Ark.
You're sure there's nothing else that needs to be done? Have all the planet's refugees made it aboard the Ark?
The ship is full and ready to fly. Thanks to you, we're about to achieve the fastest planetary evacuation in galactic history. I hope we meet again on Keylander Station.
The fuel rods are in place. Power levels are at 80%. I hope it's enough.
It'll have to be. Lemda says there's a fissure opening directly beneath us. We're launching before the Mesa collapses.
The Republic just inherited several million people who need a new home.
Please meet me in Keylander Station's conference chamber. We have much to discuss.
The Supreme Chancellor requested a meeting.
Welcome back. I was informed that you survived a terrifying ordeal. You have my deepest admiration.
Ah,
here they are.
Millions of hungry mouths to feed and nothing to show for it. You pledged Makeb to us, Shalem, and you knew it was doomed.
We had no idea the planet was that unstable. Our offer was made in good faith.
My uncle is a businessman, Chancellor. But in this case, he's telling the truth.
You knew the groundquakes were getting worse. You used the Republic, knowing we'd be obligated to help your people even if you had nothing to offer in return.
What's done is done. We have a vessel filled with millions of refugees who need food, water, and medical treatment.
And a home. My people can't live on that Ark forever. They're packed in like cargo.
This is a debacle. We came here seeking resources to defeat the Sith Empire. Instead, we're walking away with debts and obligations.
What about the Hutt leaders? You negotiated a peace agreement with them, didn't you?
He's right. The cartel leaders have promised to support the Republic wholeheartedly.
So we have a worthless ally and a broken one. Still, the Hutts possess considerable wealth. Only the cartel leaders who needed rescuing agree to this alliance. Fortunately, they possess most of the wealth and power. They'll neutralize any holdouts. With our new friends' wealth and warships, we've gained a substantial advantage over the Empire. That doesn't address the problem of Makeb's people, however. I need a solution.
The Republic needs to establish a haven for war victims. I can't think of anyone more deserving than the people of Makeb. The Hutts have plenty of credits to fund the construction of new homes. And we can use their fleet to protect them.
I had to twist your arm to call the Republic. Glad you finally swallowed that spirit of independence?
After everything we've been through, to receive such generosity. Thank you all.
The people of Makeb need someone guiding them to their new home. I think you're the right person for that job, Shalem.
I'm not. But you've shown me what a true leader looks like. I'll follow that example.
I want to speak with my operative in private.
Please excuse us. You've made the best of an unfortunate situation. Well done. The Hutts want to be on the winning side of this war, and you've shown them who that is. We have you alone to thank for this alliance.
All Jedi are taught that our power should be used to bring people together for peace.
A great many have seen your example and responded, and I need that beacon in the darkness more than ever. For too long, the Republic has wasted time reacting to the enemy. We must fight this war to win by going on the offensive. Savor this victory. Return to the war's front lines and press our advantage. Together, we will be triumphant.